Guys, in this video, let us look at the screening for diseases in blood bank. So basically, blood is collected from a donor, right? And before it is given to the patient, it should be screened. It should be screened for some certain diseases. And according to WHO guidelines, okay, so the diseases that they will screen the blood for will be HIV 1 and 2, hepatitis B and C, because these are transmitted by blood, right? Then syphilis, again transmitted by blood. Malaria, if malaria parasite is there in the peripheral smear, they will check. Then Chagas disease, brucellosis. So how will they check for HIV, guys? ELISA. How will they check for hepatitis? Again, ELISA. How will they check for syphilis? VDRL. Malaria, peripheral smear they will do of the blood, Chagas disease and brucellosis. Some tests, specific tests for these. Do you know Chagas disease? Chagas disease is actually caused by this Trypanosoma cruzi, a protist, right? And it is actually the vector for Chagas disease is this one, the Reduvid bug, okay? So if you remember from the parasitology videos, okay, so blood is checked for Chagas disease, which is caused by the protist Trypanosoma cruzi. Brucellosis is caused by a bacteria, right? And it is also, this brucellosis is also called as undulant fever, Malta fever, Mediterranean fever, okay? So many other names are there for this. So these are all the diseases that the blood is screened for in blood bank, okay? This is an image for brucellosis. Okay, so have you understood? So what and all are they screening for? I'm sure the list could be longer. However, WHO guidelines, they are mentioning HIV, hepatitis, syphilis, malaria, Chagas disease, brucellosis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Totally 6, right? Only 6 you have points you have to write if they ask this question in the exam. Okay. Screening for diseases in blood bank. That's all for now. See you in the next video. Bye bye.